guys. So I'm just back to give you guys a quick update. Yeah, I am not happy in this video whatsoever. I want to cry, but I'm not gonna cry because I'm just not. So since my last update, I had a visit to triage because I woke up with like really intense contractions, and I went to bed with really intense contractions, but they kind of like settled down a little bit for me, so I was able to fall asleep, and I think I slept for like maybe an hour and some change, and then they woke me back up, and they were like just coming, like boom, boom, boom. They were hitting really, really hard, and they were about 5 minutes apart. They were like 5 minutes apart, and so I went into labor and delivery. And I was checked, and this time I was, in my last update, I was 3 centimeters dilated, and this time I was checked, and I was 4 centimeters dilated, and the contractions were still coming. They were about 5 minutes apart, and they lasted about 2 minutes and some change, about 2 minutes and some change they lasted, and then they kind of like subsided a little bit. So I was definitely having contractions. They hooked me up to the monitor, and those contractions, I mean, they seen them. I was only hooked up to the monitor for about maybe 10-15 minutes or so, just so they could, you know, see the contractions, and then also check baby's heartbeat. She was withstanding the contractions very, very well. Her heartbeat never like decreased or dropped or anything like that, which was awesome. So after the 15 minutes on the monitor, they checked me and told me I was 4 centimeters. So what they wanted to do was have me walk. They had me walk for an hour, and then I came back to do basically like a stress test in a way, just for them to check the heartbeat, and then they had me walk some more. But as the time went by, mind you, all of this is happening between 1 a.m. and 5 a.m. in the morning, so I'm so exhausted. As they had me continue walking, the contractions started to kind of like subside or whatever. They weren't as bad, and they weren't coming on as strong as they were when I first came in. So then she checked me again at 5, and I had no progression whatsoever. She said I was still at a 4. So, which kind of like, you know, was like, I kind of figured I was. I didn't feel like I changed or anything like that, just because the contractions kind of subsided in a way. So they gave me the option to either stay another hour and see where things pick up, or go home. And I chose to come home because I'm like, I'm sitting here, I walked for 2 hours, and the contractions, you know, it didn't change my cervix, so I don't think I'm gonna change at all. So I decided to come home. And then I had a doctor's appointment this past Thursday, and I went in, and I told him, he seen that I had been into triage or whatever, and he's like, okay. So he asked me what they said, and I told him, and then he's like, what are you still doing? Why are you still pregnant? And I'm like, I know. I'm like, I don't think she wants to come. Like, so he was like, okay, well, here's what we'll do. He was like, we're gonna check you again, and if you haven't made any progression, or even if you have, do you want your membrane sweep? So I was like, yeah, let's do it. So he checked me. I was still at a 4. I did lose like a lot of mucus plug the day before my appointment, which was Wednesday. I lost a lot, like a big chunk amount of mucus plug. And then I had my membrane sweep. And I started to lose some more of it. And I would say we're working on almost 48 hours since my membrane sweep. And no contractions or anything like that. Yeah, I'm just like at a standstill. I'm having a lot of discharge with TMI, like little streaks of blood here and there, but again, nothing dramatic. And they told me that I shouldn't come back to triage unless my water breaks, which that's never happened to me. And or if my contractions pick up and are constant and they're 2 to 5 minutes apart, which I haven't had really no contractions. So I'm kind of like, I don't know. I'm starting to like, I don't know. I don't want to get into it because I don't want to cry. I don't know, like, I feel like, you know, because this is my third pregnancy and that it should be moving along some type of way, but it's not, and I'm just getting really frustrated. My family and friends, they call me like every single day. That's irritating too, because they call me every single day and they're like, you know, is the baby coming today? And I'm like, no, like, stop calling me. I don't want to sound like, you know, mean or anything, but it's getting really frustrated because it's like I'm doing everything to try to push this labor on. And you would think that, you know, she told me that if I were having my baby in the actual hospital, that they would have kept me and just, you know, basically helped me to keep the contractions going or whatever. So, but because I'm having my baby at the birth center, they want me to be at least 5 to 6 or 7 centimeters dilated and before they will even admit me. So I'm just getting kind of like frustrated at this point. Yeah, I'm getting really irritated. Not at her, not at the baby or anything like that, because again, I know that baby will come when she wants to, but yeah, so that's pretty much the update. I'm still 132 pounds, and so that's not changed at all. Yeah, that's pretty much it. So I just wanted to, you know, get this video out and share with you what's been going on for these last couple of days. I'll see you guys for a week 38 update. My doctor doesn't think that I will make it to my 38 week appointment because he stripped my membranes and because he said the baby's head was right there and the sac was bulging. But I just don't see any change. Yeah, so I will see you guys for week 38. Thanks for watching. Bye, guys.